We will solve this Irodov problem, which is based on the Gauss law for the dielectrics. And here you have a electrode, which is two electrodes, which are like concentric spherical shaped. This is electrode one, this is electrode two. These are both in the shape of a sphere and they have space in between them. And the charge given to this capacitor, which basically two electrodes, they make a capacitor. So they are making a capacitor, the charge given to it is Q. So Q is the total charge which is given to it. So there will be plus Q somewhere and minus Q on the other plate. And this charge, please note, remains conserved until unless we earth it or we short circuit it or we connect to some other capacitor. So when charge is given, it means you have to take it conserved. This capacitor, which is having two electrodes, which are spheres, which are concentric spheres, is filled with the uniform isotropic dielectric, which fills half of this space, and half of the space you have vacuum or air. Now we have to find what will be the electric field at any place which is at a distance r, here and here. A few things we have to keep in mind. This electrode is a conducting plate. This electrode is a conducting plate. This conducting plate will have same potential on it. This will also have same potential, but the two potentials will be different. These two potentials will be different, but the potential is same across. So the potential difference is same all across. When the potential difference is same all across, means electric field in this region has to be equal to electric field in that region. The only way it is possible, because of after putting the electric field remains constant, is that in such situations the charge realigns. Here Q1 will come and here Q2 will come, where Q1 plus Q2 is equal to Q. So this is the issue in this problem, basically solved by using this. Rest is all very easy. Now you have to apply the Gauss law for the two regions. One is the region where there is no dielectric, another is the region where there is a dielectric. You know the Gauss law is E dot ds is equal to total Q upon epsilon naught. This is the Q enclosed, which is the free charge. This is for the vacuum or space. But for the dielectric, the Gauss law becomes Q upon K epsilon naught. We call it Gauss law for the dielectric. So this will be applied in this region and this will be applied in this region. This is point number two of the problem. Now let me first apply Gauss law in the upper region. What do I do? I take a hemisphere and this is the hemisphere I take. This is the hemisphere which is the electrode which is inside. This is the inside electrode I am showing, which has total charge equal to Q1, which is distributed only on this surface. You don't have anything here, it's open. This charge is distributed here, there is nothing here, it's open. And the charge will give the electric field which is normal to its surface. Like this, the electric field will cross this Gaussian surface like this. Another thing which we have to keep in mind, that in case of conducting material, the whole charge resides outside. So this charge what I am showing here actually is on the surface, is on the outer surface. There is no charge inside. This whole charge is actually outside. So there has to be no electric field in this direction, because this charges which are there on this hemisphere shape can only flow like give electric field in this direction. There is no way that it can give electric field here. It cannot be, because there is no charge inside. And this also cannot give electric field here. So when I apply the Gauss law, I take the two regions. One is this region and another is the bottom region. Bottom region is as good as not there, because E dot ds here will be zero. Though you have the area, area is pi r square, but this part is zero. So my E dot ds for bottom part is zero. So total E dot ds for the top part was Q1 upon epsilon naught. So the curved part has E 2 pi r square is the area, surface area, curved surface area of the hemisphere, and plus 0 is for the bottom part because no electric field, q1 upon epsilon naught. So I get value of E is q1 upon twice pi r square and epsilon naught here. I apply the same thing for the part where you have the dielectric, but the difference is here you will have to apply the Gauss law for the dielectric. And this is the surface, similar surface I draw. Take this hemisphere, which is bottom, and it has charge equal to Q2. And take a Gaussian surface in the space in between the two electrodes, which has, say, radius R. And same principle will apply here as it had applied there. And no electric field will be here. So E dot ds for this region is 0 for the bottom region. And for this region, E dot ds is how much? Is equal to E into 2 pi into r square. Both added gives the E into 2 pi r square. This is actually E dot ds for the whole area. This comes this because the other part is 0 is equal to Gauss law for dielectric. The charge enclosed is Q2. Q2 upon K into epsilon naught. So you get electric field as Q2 upon twice pi r square epsilon naught into k. Both the electric fields are equal, so it means that Q1 is equal to Q2 upon k. So Q2 is Q1 times k. Q1 times k, and you put here, so Q1 plus Q1 times k is equal to Q. So Q1 is equal to Q upon 1 plus K, and Q2 is equal to K times Q upon 1 plus K. So put the value of Q1 here and you get the electric field. Electric field is Q1 is Q upon 1 plus K will come here, and it is twice pi R square into epsilon naught. I forgot to mention, which I should have mentioned in the beginning, K is the dielectric constant, which is the relative permittivity. In the book, it is given as, in Irodov, they give the permittivity like this. And we are used to taking K, which is dielectric constant, which is same as relative permittivity. What Irodov gives you is the relative permittivity, which is in this shape, epsilon. And we are using relative permittivity, but we call it, it is same thing, call it dielectric constant, and we use K. That is why I have used the K in this case.